Dear students, today we are going to study about the engine cooling system and lubrication system of an automotive engine. So this is our lab seat and you can see the apparatus. So why this cooling system used in an automotive engine? Okay, normally the engine working in a certain value of temperature, that's called the engine working temperature. Okay, here that mentioned 94 degrees Celsius. Okay, if that engine temperature increase than this value or reduced, what will happen? There is a improper combustion may take place, or and the engine may damage. Okay, so the engine working under that operation temperature, that means the engine working very efficiently and effectively, okay, in that temperature. Okay, so that is the, this is the around the same as the engine working temperature. Okay, so there are two types of cooling system. First, air cooling system. So there are metal fins using metal fins on the outer perimeter of the engine use the air cool systems. Here you can see this type of arrangement, metal arrangement, structure arrangement in the engine. This normally you can see, I think, yeah, in the motorbikes or in the car engines, this type of metal structure widely used. Here, because of this arrangement, that heat, that excess heat released from the engine to atmosphere very easily. Okay, so this motivate the cooling system. Okay, the second cooling system is liquid cooling system. So these are the parts of the liquid cooling system. We study by an animation video. So the cooling system parts: water pump, radiator, thermostat, cooling temperature sensor and coolant. So this is the parts. This is the water pump and radiator. Here thermostat valve and the temperature sensor. Okay, so you can see this is the passage. This is the passage of the coolant flow. So that coolant in is here. So there is a passage. That's mean area. It's a hole. It's like a cave. Okay, there is a passage inside the engine block. So this coolant circulate through this passage. Here you can see the red or orange color coolant. That means normally in the coolant enters from the radiator is like a, there is a very low temperature. That means it's very cool. Okay, this low temperature increase, then it absorb the heat of the engine, then the coolant become very hot temperature. Okay, so after some time that coolant gets the high temperature and is leaves through this line. Okay, Here you can see them. Yeah, this is the water pump. This is connect with the crankshaft pulley, and here this is the tensioner, the small pulley is, and this is connect with the belt, serpentine belt. So first we see how this water pump works and the cut model of this pump. You can see the pump here. This is, there is a rotary wheel that's called impeller here. Okay, so the coolant enter here. Okay, so this impeller is rotated like this. So what will happen? This coolant is pulled by a force because of this rotation. Okay, then this coolant is push. Here is pull and here this is push by this rotation. Okay, it's like the same as the pump. Okay, here there is a outlet, here this is here inlet. Okay, so this is the pump arrangement. So now let's see the connections. So one connection is bypass valve. So there is the thermostat housing. Inside that thermostat is fixed. So there is a radiator with radiator fan, and the lower, this is the lower hose pipe, and this upper radiator hose. Okay, and the coolant expansion tank, this is. Okay, here inside there is a thermostat. Okay, we are see this thermostat is always, thermostat is always connect with the outlet of the engine. Okay, the coolant leave from this area. Okay, that is called outlet. Okay, this is fixed with outlet. So this is the main outlet, this is the main pipe. Okay, this is the bypass line, and that is water pump. Okay, so normally the coolant is filled with the fill in this area. Okay, this thermostat area normally is coolant is fill here. This is the bypass valve, is normally open. That means this cool tank, this coolant is flow through this bypass line. So this is the bypass line, this is the main line. Okay, this is the main line. So that's the cold time. What will happen? Let's see. Now see, this is the bypass line. Okay, so the cooling time. So you just think the vehicle, now we start the vehicle. Okay, so this temperature is increased from 0 to our working temperature, I mean 94 degree. Okay, it's increase until it achieve the 94 degree Celsius. We don't need to cool the engine, because in the engine must work this operation operating temperature. Okay, so there is no cooling procedure needed until it achieve the 94 degree Celsius. Okay, so until it achieve 94 degree Celsius, what will happen? This coolant use this bypass line. Okay, so the coolant leave from this engine and is flow through this bypass line. Then here this is the water pump. So just think, this is a radiator, the radiator input lines come like this. So there is an impeller inside the water pump. Here there is a rotator like this. Okay. So that pull the water. Okay. So this intake water from the radiator and this input coolant from the bypass line from the thermostat outlet, both are connected into this water pump and it supply to engine. Okay, this is the normal operation in the cooling time. Cooling time means cold time. Okay, when the engine get high temperature or that's achieve that working temperature, what will happen? Let's see. Okay. Now you can see this change, by changing this color, this coolant is now got the engine operation temperature. So this coolant need to involve the cooling process. Okay, now the cooling get high temperature or where, okay, absorbs the heat. Okay, is need to involve the cooling process. So now this coolant need to send the radiator. So here you can see when the temperature increase, this lever is move downwards, so this valve is open. Okay, now you can see this main line is open, so that coolant flow through this line to radiator, and here this is the intake line from the radiator. So now we study how this thermostat control. There's two way. Okay, one is bypass line, another is main line. How it controls the two way arrangement? So you can see this is the thermostat. Okay, here in the normal time, cold coolant from the engine, there is a bypass line. Okay, it's normally open the cold time, so this coolant flow through this bypass line. At the same time, there is a plate here, like a plate, different plate. So this is the main line. Now this main line is close by this plate. This plate means there is a small plate inside of this. Okay, now this is, that is closed. Okay, when that hot temperature or hot coolant, what will happen? You can see there is a, this is like a shaft or lever, there is a wax. That's wax cooling. That's wax like a gel, or you can see the wax is the candles also manufactured by that wax. It has a low melting point. That means when it absorbs the heat or temperature, it acts like a thermal expander. Okay, it need to expand. Okay, here that's wax it fill here. This is a closed area. Okay, I explain clearly by another photo. That is clear. Okay, okay, you can see this is a cold time. Okay, normally there's flow through this bypass line. Okay, here this orange color is wax. Okay, this lever is fixed stationary. That means it's not move. Okay, but we can move this. This area we can move. Okay, totally we can move. But this shaft we cannot move. That's fixed here. Okay, we can move this total area. Okay, so just think, this axis expand. Okay, expand mean this volume is increase. Okay, so it needs some more area to fill. Okay, so according to that pressure, what will happen? This is more, just think this is like a room. Okay, so there are some space. Now you can see the orange color is the vacuum of space. Okay, so now this increased, this volume is increased, wax, what will happen? These parts move downwards. Okay, now you can see it's moved downwards. Okay, first you can see this point, this is located here first, now it's located here. This is the starting point, is now this is end position. Okay, what will happen? It move downwards. Okay, now according to that, this wax get more area. You can see that orange color and here. Okay, this wax is expand. Okay, because of the expansion, this part is move downwards. So there is a, you can see there is a like a plate or diagram like this. Okay, so here is totally closed, this main area totally closed. Here you can see this plate. Okay, this plate move downwards. Now there is a gap in the both side. Okay, so what will happen when the temperature increase? This wax get more thermal expansion. Okay, so this part is moved downwards, so there is a gap. So this coolant move through this main line. So that time you can see. Okay, so okay, now this is open, this area. Okay, this is open. Okay, you can see now this area is open, move through this cool. Okay, then how it achieved by that bypass line? When it is open, the bypass line is get close. Okay, so it's move downwards. Okay, what will happen? This close, this bypass line. Okay, so the bypass line is open, this main line is closed, the main line is open, the bypass line is getting close. Okay, so this how that thermostat control the two way flow. Okay, so now there now that coolant is move towards the radiator. Okay, so as we study about your radiator, we know, we just study about the radiator. Okay, there's a cut model. Yeah, you can see here. Okay, this is the cut model of radiator. This is the radiator cap. Okay, you can see here also there is a cooling fins. Okay, this is so same as that air cooling. Here also the cooling fins. Okay, here radiator fan. When the fan rotates, the atmosphere air intake through this radiator. Okay, oh, along with this radiator, what will happen? This going coolant going to cool. Okay, so there is a upper tank here, so then this is a outlet pipe, upper hose pipe, so coolant come from the engine. Okay, here that coolant is stored, and then there is a, you can see there is a core tube, there is a tin tube, so that coolant then travel by this pipe. Okay, this pipe until it gets the bottom tank. There is another tank, that is bottom tank. So between this area, that hot temperature coolant getting low temperature. Okay, that means that reduce this cooling process, reduce the temperature of the coolant. Okay, so one is the airflow. Okay, because of the airflow, this coolant temperature is going to reduce. So here you can see another, this is the transmitter oil cooler. This is also fixed with the radiator. Okay, so what is that? Here also you can see this. This is a transmission oil cooler. What is transmission oil cooler? This is normally in the automotive automotive gear. Okay, some the vehicles which have automotive gearbox. Okay, so that automotive transmission oil need to cool. Okay, so this is a radiator. This super cooler also fixed with that radiator. So this transmission oil also cooled by this radiator, because it's fixed with this radiator. The reason is there's a common fan. Okay, that there's a common fan radiator. So that fans also fan intake the air from the atmosphere. So this supercooler also fixed with that radiator. Okay. Okay, now we see the animation video. I have to tell one thing. Here there is a sensor. Okay, this sensor measure the temperature of the engine or the thermostat. Okay, so in the engine know when the thermostat open, which temperature the thermostat is going to open the main line. Okay, that time that radiator pan begin to work. Okay, because this coolant is sent to radiator. Okay, for a cooling process, so that fans need to work. So when this is absorb the temperature, when the thermostat is open the main valve, okay, this fan start to work, because this signal is data is sent to ECU, that ECU control the radiator fan. So now this radiator fan is working. Okay, so you can see that track the atmosphere air, that fan is like a ventilation fan. Okay, so now that is right. So in the upside of the radiator there is a cap. Okay, it is called pressure cap. Okay, here there is a spring mechanism used. Okay, you can see. So what is the use of this pressure cap? Okay, this is upside of the in the upper surface of the radiator. So normally this coolant is this is the hot temperature coolant. Okay, because it's leave from the engine. So so this coolant that mean produce a high pressure. Okay, sometimes it make produce a high pressure. So here when the, it absorb the pressure, okay, this spring is absorb pressure, okay, this spring can absorb 15 psi pressure. This pressure is increased, what will happen if there is no pressure gap? This air parts of this radiator may damage or burn, okay, by this high pressure. So this pressure is increased than 15 psi, what will happen? This spring going to move upwards because of this pressure of the coolant, okay. So there is a way here, there is a path or pipe here, okay. This pipe is connect with the expansion coolant there, where the coolant store, okay. So that pressure is going to increase. So this is the pipe, release pipe is connect with the expansion coolant expansion tank, okay. What is this? So there is a two process, okay. One, if the radiator pressure is increase than 15 psi, what will happen? It move, the spring is of the pressure gap is move upwards and this line is open. This coolant is travel to this expansion tank until the pressure reduce below the 15 psi, okay. After it achieved the 15 psi, then it's going to this spring is moves is remains is remain as the same or previous position, okay. So the other thing, so this engine coolant temperature is reduced, okay. What will happen if reduced, okay, what will happen? There is a vacuum here because this valve is closed, this valve is now closed, okay. So there is no coolant in the pipe, so there is a vacuum, there is a space or area, okay. Because of the vacuum, then this coolant flow through this direction, okay. This direction and is going to serve this upper tank and is used for the engine cooling, okay. How it achieve the two operation, how it achieved by this pressure gap, okay. Let's see. Okay. Here, first we are pressure gap. So you can see here. This is the pressure gap. There is a spring. Okay. Normally this is the way. Now this is closed by. So this lower ceiling gasket. Okay. What will happen? It's going to move this way, okay. So this coolant is flow through this pipe, okay. This is the pressure condition, okay. You can see a small disc like this, okay, the shape of disc, okay. When the vacuum, okay. So now this is the wiper, okay. When the condition of the that low temperature condition, this disc, only this disc move downwards, okay. That means that big plate is remain as the same position. This is move this way. So there is a hole. Okay. So here there is a expansion tear. So when we absorb the vacuum, when it's absorb the vacuum, that's coolant flow back. Okay. Come like this, and there is a hole, and move like this to radiator. Okay. This is capper. There is a photo. You can clearly see. Okay. So this is a pressure valve condition. That means there is a pressure condition. Okay. This spring move upwards. So there is a gap. Is move to tank. Here. Okay. Here you can see this fluid cannot move because there is no gap here. Okay, this are closed. Okay, now this low temperature, what will happen? There is a vacuum. Okay, this is tank. There is a vacuum here, space. Okay, that time this part only. Okay, that hole. This is called pressure valve. Okay. This is called pressure valve. This is the pressure valve. This part only called vacuum valve. Okay. When vacuum increase in this pipe, what will happen? This part only move downwards. Okay. So what will happen? This again flow. The coolant flow back from the expansion tank, and is move along this passage and is enter to radiator, the upper tank of the radiator. Okay. This how the pressure cap controls the flow of two different condition. One is pressure condition and is other is vacuum condition. Okay. So now pressure condition. Okay. Now vacuum condition. So you can see there is another pipe here. This is what is this? Just see what happened. That's a overflow course. Okay. What happen if the sometimes this coolant completely fill in this tank, what will happen? There is a pressure because there is no open line. Okay, this tank is completely closed. Okay. Okay, so how it reduce its pressure, or it's sometimes in the tank have the air bubbles or anything. Okay, so how we cannot reduce the pressure in the inside pressure of the tank. So there is an overflow pipe. So this coolant level is increased or anything. This overflow tank, the coolant in the okay, that extra coolant exit from this overflow tank. Okay. So there is a heater system. How to tell? Here I think is we cannot see the heater system because our country is normally it have a temperature. Okay. When we can see in the foreign countries where is they face the winter. Okay. Winter season, We normally use the air conditioning system inside the vehicle, okay? We don't need any heater system. But in the foreign countries, they use the heater system during the winter season, okay? Winter season, they use the heater system, okay? How this heater system works, okay? Here you can see, this is called heater core, okay? This is called heater core. There are two pipes, okay? This is an inlet pipe. The hot coolant, there is another line, okay? This connect with the outlet, engine outlet, okay? So that hot coolant is come to this core, and here there is a coolant is, this is the outlet line, this is connect with the intake line of the water pump, okay? So how it works, let's see. Heater core, so that is inlet core, this is outlet core, they are the control valve. Additionally, there is a air conditioner blower, okay? It's normally situated in the near to the dashboard, okay? This is normally situated in the dashboard of the vehicle. That means, for an example, this is the vehicle, this is the front side of the vehicle, okay? Radiator is situated like this. This blower is normally blower, and this heater core is situated in this area, okay? So what will happen? The blower, what is blower? The AC blower is likely is connected with the motor. It's a rotates, okay? It's rotate like this. According to the rotates, they are vents, okay? They are like a passage vents. So according to the, this is the same as the water pump. According to this rotates, it's pull or push the air, okay? That air, because this hot coolant flow through this heater core, okay? So that core absorb the heat, and this is send the heat through this blower, okay? So this blower pass the heat, the air pass the heating air because of this rotation, okay? So that, because that heat is absorbed by the heater core, then this coolant lost its heat, okay? That's why it's connect with the intake line, because this is also work as like a radiator, okay? Here this compressor can use the two-way rotate, that means the compressor used for intake air or some other air we can release from the car to atmosphere, okay? Like a ventilation, okay? So this type of this blower is working to pull or push the air by its rotation. So we studied about pressure cap. Before that 1970s, the cap normally used, because now the pressure cap is released when the high pressure condition, the pressure cap release the pressure to expansion tank, okay? But before 1970s vehicles, okay, that extra pressure is released to pavement. That means this is a pressure cap, okay? Normally now the modern vehicles have is released by vacuum, but in the 1970s that pressure is released by this gap, okay, to atmosphere, okay? This coolant pressure is released by there's a small gap. That's a one valve. That's working like a valve. The atmosphere, air cannot enter inside of this valve. Only one way direction. This pressure release to atmosphere. Okay. But this is the open circuit. Now this is the closed side. That is, this is the closed system because this pressure is released to the coolant is released to the tank, and then the tank send the coolant to radiator. So this is the now these modern vehicles use the closed cooling system. Another thing I have to tell, the another cooling system, I think you can see like this. Okay, there is a simol. This is the radiator. Okay, this is the simol. It's like type of simol radiator. There is a two connection, inlet and outlet. What is this? You can see this we can call this turbo intercooler. Okay, the some diesel vehicles normally use this, not the diesel, and the petrol also use the turbo. Okay, but is turbo. Okay, this is also type of cooling system. This is not in the lap seat, but I tell additionally because this is also important. Okay, let's see an animation. Yeah, you can see this is the turbo. Why turbo juice? What is the benefit or advantage of turbo system? Okay. Here you can see, you already know this area. What is this? Piston, cylinder, everything. This is the intake manifold. This is the exhaust. Okay. This is the part I shown that is connected with, that is fixed with the radiator. Okay. Because this is fixed with the radiator because of that, there is a one fan used for the cooling process. Okay. That's why. So, what is the benefit of this turbo system? So there is a common wheel here. Normally use, you can see the normal vehicle have how there is a air filter. Okay, this is the air filter. This air filter is connect like this with this engine. Okay, they so the air flow through this manifold. You just think it's a normal process. If we fix a rotation wheel, like say water pump or something, no? What will happen? Because of rotation, the more air can pull into this manifold. Okay, because of this rotation, the much air can pull. Okay, because of that, the rich air mixture, air is, we can get the air, and because of that we can reduce the fuel amount and we get a better combustion. Okay, and better combustion, better economy and best performance. Okay, because in the normal most of the racing car use this turbo technology. Okay, because they since intake air is high, but just think there is no any if we rotate this wheel, we have to fix a motor additionally to rotate this wheel. Instead of that, here you can see this is the exhaust manifold, this is also a wheel, this is also a wheel, both are connect with the same shaft. Okay, so after this exhaust process, this piston push this air and this air exit through this line with a high force, or it's more very with a high force, because this piston push this air. Okay, what will happen? The air move like this, so the rod and this side wheel is rotate by this. When the exhaust process, this wheel is rotate by this exhaust air. Okay, so what will happen? This wheel will rotate, they are same shaft, so this wheel also rotate. Okay, so now it's connected like this. Now I erase these things. Okay, now air filter is here. Okay, what will happen in the exhaust process? This wheel is rotates. Okay, so according to that, this intake wheel is located, so this air is pulled. When the exhaust time, this air is rotate, that time this air is pulled by this wheel. Okay, so much air come to this engine. Okay, so because when we take this cylinder after the exhaust, so there is a next cycle. So the first step is intake. After this exhaust process, we need to give the air. Oh, we have to supply the air for the intake process. So that is achieved by the same wheel. So why this intercooler? Why this intercooler? Because of this process, or this atmosphere temperature, this air may be very hot. So when we supply the hot air inside the engine, what will happen? I already told, the engine works a certain amount of working temperature. Okay, sometimes that working temperature may increase. Okay, sometimes we can get a improper air fuel mixture because of the temperature. At the same other thing, this air temperature is increase, the density of air is reduced. Okay, because of that, density is reduced, we cannot mix properly with the fuel. Okay, so we cannot obtain a proper fuel air fuel mixture. So that's why this is also work like a radiator. This is cool because the air flow through this intercooler, the air, okay, so this air involves participate a cooling process. Okay, so here we can get a cool air. So this is the turbo intercooler. Okay, so this is also the cooling system of engine. Okay, so now you can see. So here you can see. Here exhaust manifold. Okay, what is that? Exhaust manifold come like this. This is the going to the silencer. Okay, fix here. That's a manifold. This is a silencer. So this wheel is rotates. Some wheels are, it's depend on the cycle. Sometimes wheels will connect with any pulley. Okay, so because we connect with this pulley, this shaft, we can get more effective. Okay, normally this wheel is rotating, but when this exhaust process, this wheel rotation is, we need this wheel rotation, but normally the wheel is rotate, is basically get connect with any pulley or something. Okay, so when this exhaust air is come to like this, the wheels rotate high speed. Okay, so this is normally rotates the 360,000 RPM. The wheel is rotated. So then what will happen? So that's intake air is come this to this manifold according to the wheel rotation, it is enter or pull to intake manifold. Okay, this is the process of turbo intercooler. Now we study about the lubrication system, engine lubrication. What is lubrication? Okay, what is lubrication? Why this lubrication use in an automotive engine? Okay, because in the mostly this automatic engine is working by the mechanical, okay, mechanically works. So there are a lot of moving parts. Okay, so between these moving parts, the friction can absorb. Okay, the friction. So because the engine oil provides a moderate of cooling, that means we can use the engine oil or lubrication, any lubrication grease or anything. Okay, to prevent damage by friction between the two or more moving parts. Moreover, okay, then engine oil also provide of method of cooling engine parts. Okay, that means that are not cooled by the engine cooling system. Some parts upon the cooling coolant is not enter to some parts. Okay, for coolant. So this oil, this engine oil or this lubrication material also cool some engine parts. Okay, some parts that is cannot cool by this cooling system, this engine oil provides a cooling. Okay, method of cooling. Okay, the other thing, the engine oil helps to protect engine components from horizon. Horizon by neutralizing harmful chemicals that are by product of combustion. What is horizon? You know the horizon because the material lost its natural quality. Okay, so this is occurred by, this surface is occurred by the oxide or some chemical. That's why when after servicing vehicles, when we when servicing vehicle after water wash, they spray the oil on the metal body part. What's because that oil works like a cover, or that means, okay, it's like a cover oil. Okay, so that oxide or something chemical cannot touch straightly. Okay, because that oil film, that means there is a thin layer. Okay, that oil layer prevent the metal parts by this from this chemicals or some oxide or something. Okay, that is horizon. Okay, so this lubrication systems, what are the advantage or useful of this lubrication system? Okay, okay, let's see how this lubrication system works in a engine. Okay, we watch animation lubrication system. Okay, here you can see this is called a strainer. Okay, this is the oil pump. This is inside the oil sump. This is a sump. Okay, you can see this is the crankshaft. This is the crankshaft. Okay, this is the oil sump. That means like a metal casing where the oil store. Okay, so we have to maintain a particular level of oil. Okay, because we can the oil gauge, oil meter, we can measure the level of the oil. Okay, here there is a oil filter. Okay, this is a pressure regulator valve. So here we can measure the pressure, engine oil pressure. Okay, there is an indicator, the engine oil indicator in the dashboard. There's LED, there's a LED panel in the dashboard. We can see the oil indicator. Okay, here this oil pump is connect with the belt. By the belt is also connect with the crankshaft or camshaft. No, is connect with another pulley of crankshaft. Here you can see crankshaft. This is a piston. So there is a path, because this we can normally use a pipe. Why this strainer? Because strainer like a use like a floater. That means it's like a, it's also clean the particles, small particles or dust. Okay, from the oil, it allowed to intake the clean oil. That means it's purify. It's purify the dust or anything. This strainer. Okay, then is the oil flow through this pipe. Because of this pump rotation, this pump pull this oil. Okay, this oil flow through this pressure regulator. This is the secondary. Okay, additionally this is also say work as a filter, and mainly this is also the oil filter. This is a main filter. Again, this is also purify the dust or particles. Okay, here the pressure regulator also normally it's adjusted according to this pressure into this line. This valve can be pressure regulator valve can be adjusted. Okay, so here you can see this the oil part line. Okay, these lines normally in the cylinder engine block, they are the small hole. That means they are the small passage. Okay, so this oil enter to this passage. Okay, this oil enter to this passage. So there is a here also said. Okay, so this means spout. Spout means this like a gun, sprayer. Okay, so the oil come to like this. Here there is a, this is a crankshaft. Crankshaft also have some tiny hole. That means a small passage. You can see that crankshaft. Okay, here also there is a small passage, and the oil can enter to this passage. Then here also the oil can enter to this passage. Because you can see here are some bearings. Because this is the connecting rod. So this connecting rod connect with this crankshaft. Between that there is a bearing. Okay, so this type of area the coolant cannot enter. Oh, this is a high moving parts. Okay, so this main oil come and travel through this line. Okay, what will happen here? There is a bearing, connection bearing. This oil supply to that bearing also. Okay, that there is a spout. This spout spray. Okay, this spout spray the oil. Okay, Here also then another line is going to like this. Here also sprout, it's also spray. Two. What is it? This is the valve, okay? This is the valve. This is the rocker. The rocker arm before we in the first experiment we adjust the valve. This is like this. This rocker. That means this kind of. This is the gap we measured. This is the rocker arm. Okay. The rocker arm. Or sometimes there is a push rod. That means overhead valve. The camshaft is not the upside. Okay. The downside there is a cam. These type of valves connect with the push rod. Okay. You know here that's valve. Okay. It's connect with the push rod. So this lubrication can enter through this rod. Okay. For lubricating this rocker arm and push rod. Okay. Because there is a small passage, small hole. Okay. So this this is enter to this here, and this sprout also spray. Sprout also spray the oil. Okay. Now you can see how it's work. Belt, some oil pump, then through the belt and pulley arrangement. Okay, there's a strainer, collects and filter oil and some due to the suction created by the oil pump. Okay, this sucks. So the service is supplied to secondary oil filter through the oil pressure regulator. So here that the oil filter is purify or clean the dust or any other particles, dust particle or any. Okay. Then this oil is travels from the air filter to, so this is a pressurized oil. What do you mean pressurized? Because the oil pump is working, is pressurized the oil. Okay, so it's going when the because here you can see the crank arrangement is like this. Normally you can see the crank like this and come to this is a both side. Okay, here a piston is connect like this. Okay, here also a piston is connect like this. Sorry, this side here also a piston is connect like this. Okay, this is the arrangement of crank. So the oil passage is come to like this. Okay, that is shown here. Okay, the crankshaft is a continuous shaft, not break like this. So this is as an animation. Okay, so the main bearing, the crankshaft bearing will locate those they are sprout. The sprout, spray the oil to the inside wall of the cylinder and piston, and the piston rings also. The oil rings. There is oil rings. You know, here there is oil rings piston. That's also lubricated by this oil. So another line going through the valve arrangement. Okay, that is a camshaft sprout. So that is also spray, because there are a lot of moving parts in the rocker arm, the push rod, okay. So that moving parts also lubricated by this engine oil. After that, there is a exit passage, okay. So this oil is supplied to, this oil is supplied to lubricate. After, we need to store the oil to in the oil sump, okay. So what will happen? There is a return line after lubricate. The oils return through by this through the return lines like this, okay. There is a return line here. Yes. Oh, by the return lines, and it's again store the oil sump. So here you, we can see the pressure gauge, the oil, the pressure of the oil, engine oil. Okay, then it's all are returned to sump. Okay, so the engine oil continuously use and store like this until it lost its structure or its that mean its durability, okay. There is a duration or there is a working arrangement. Some people normally in the vehicles are, so only you we can use 5000 kilometer for the engine oil, then we need to change the engine oil every 5000 kilometer, okay. So until that 5000 kilometer, this oil is restored and sent to replicate and restore like this, okay. So no any external supply or everything. If in the this oil is, so this if or this oil is reduced the level, there are some fault in your fault or any errors inside this engine working condition, okay. That's why this oil is ready, oil levels reduced. Otherwise this oil levels cannot be changed, okay, because there is no wastage oil. It's used for lubrication and is again stored in this sump, okay. Okay. Oh, that's a crankshaft also have the passage, okay. I show in the animation. I show, so the system lubricate everything, and so there is sometimes when we sprout the spray the oil, okay. The what is splash replication means? Splash means when a liquid strike or fall in a surface or something, it's produce a noise, the liquid, okay. Falls or strike with any surface, there is a noise, that's called splash, okay. When the spray when we spray, okay, what will happen? The oil strike with the strike with the cylinder wall, so any metal surface, so that's called splash lubrication. So that's also, then the valves arrangement, the camshaft, lifters, some overhead valves. The overhead valves, I told, they are in the camshaft in the downside, so that valve is connected with a length push rod, okay. So there are some bearings on push rods also. Also lubricate because of that that's oil passages, okay. Look, and then return to crankshaft by the return holes in the cylinder. It is then picked up by the oil pump to circulate again, okay. So it's recirculate, this is continuously is circulate until the new oil need to change. So this is the lubrication system, you can see this figure. I saw this is this photo. This is, I think, the same. Oh, so I saw this operation by the animation video. I think that that is more clear than this picture. So these are the discussions you have to write in your coursework. Additionally, I give one extra discussion. Okay. In the liquid cooling system, okay, the liquid cooling system, the liquid cooling system, what are the failures you can observe in the liquid cooling system? Sometimes that pressure cup may not working properly, or any radiator failures. Okay, so you have to mention the failures. Okay, failures. Failures in a liquid cooling system. Symptoms. How you can identify that kind of failures? Okay, and if you have find any solution for that failure, you have to mention that. That solution. Okay, so the liquid cooling system, the failures, symptoms of that failures, and what are the solution? If you have find any solution, you write. But the failure and symptoms are very important. You have to you should write these things. This is the extra discussion part. Okay, I have add here. So this is the end of the tutorial part. Next we start the practical with our apparatus. Okay. Now we are going to study a liquid type cooling system. This is the radiator, and here you can see the radiator pan behind the radiator. This is the pressure cap, and here coolant expansion tank, and you can see the level of the coolant. This is the outlet line from the engine to radiator. And I already told about the temperature sensor. Now you can see there. So it measures the temperature of the engine. This one. Okay. And this is the bypass line from thermostat valve to it's connect with the inlet line of the water pump. Okay, you can see the water pump because it's inside the metal body. This is the inlet line from radiator to engine. So this is the outlet main line, inlet main line, and this is the bypass line of between the radiator and engine. Okay. Here you can see a pipe that is a pressure relief or vacuum pipe. Okay, when pressure increased a particular value, this pressure cap receive the coolant. So this expansion tank store that coolant, and when the low temperature reduced, then this pressure cap release the valve and it's allowed to enter the coolant again. So now you can see coolant level of coolant. So okay, if there is you can't see any coolant when open this cap, that means there is any leakage, because in the radiator or any exhaust pipes, so this is okay now because we can see the coolant here. Okay, so now we check the pressure cap. So this is the spring. You can see how it works. Okay, now I hold between my fingers. This is the completely, this is the pressure valve,
and you can see a black color separate. Okay, this part only called vacuum valve. So you can see that there is a gap. So in the vacuum condition, so in the for coolant from expansion tank come through this gap. Okay, so you can see that is a vacuum valve. Okay. So now you can see very clearly, there is a gap. Okay. So this part only I call in my finger. That is, oh, that's this total part is normally the completely presser valve. Okay. You cannot open this presser gap when while the engine working, because that time that cooler temperature may very high, so it may cause any harmful accident on your body. In tutorial I told about the turbo intercooler. So here you can see this is the radiator. Additionally you can see the small size shape of radiator, and this is called turbo intercooler. Okay, AC situated near to the radiator. Okay, and this is the air filter, and the line intake line come from air filter to it's going to the turbo. Okay, this is the turbo, and this is the exhaust manifold connect with the turbo. There are two rotating wheel in one shaft. Okay, this is inside the this turbo. This will rotate like this, so the air from air filter come through this wheel and it's go to turbo intercooler because of this wheel rotation. Okay, so this this is the exhaust manifold, so it's connect with another wheel and is push the air towards the silencer pipe. You can see the silencer. So this line, so this line from the turbo, it's connected to the turbo intercooler because because of this process, so any atmosphere temperature, the intake air may very heat. So that air came from come from air filter that is under the cooling process into this turbo intercooler. Okay, finally after the air cools down, this turbo intercooler send the air to intake manifold. So finally this air is supplied to the combustion process. Okay, this is the end of the practical. I hope I explain clearly. Okay, thank you.